Hello, crafty friends! Marine here for Landfun. Thanks for stopping by. Today we are getting spooky with three cheeky kitties who meet by the magic cauldron to experiment with new spells. So those kitties and all the magic accessories are from the new Perfectly Wicked and the add-on. My card also features the broom and a bunch of cute tiny spiders from Booya, the fireplace from Christmas Dreams, the witch hat from Happy Halloween. I also picked the pumpkins from Happy Harvest. I chose the center picture window die set to set my little spooky scene. And I used the Simple Stripes landscape backdrop to create a wooden floor. I started with the background and cut a center picture window panel out of Bristol cardstock. I took my brick stencil out and picked three oak sidings to create a magical spooky wall. I taped the panel to my glass surface to keep it in place and taped the brick stencil on top. And I applied the inks on the top section of the center picture window panel. And to get a nice brick effect, I didn't make big circle moves. I just kind of tap my blending tool onto the stencil. This way the stencil doesn't move and we get a nice and defined brick texture. I applied the inks pretty randomly. I wasn't looking for a specific look. I just tapped my blending tool here and there, and as always, I went back and forth with the different colors to blend everything as nicely as possible. And I think that this color combination would definitely be amazing for a space or a galaxy themed card as well. So I removed the stencil, it looked pretty good to me. So I moved on and added more details to this brick wall, starting with some water droplets to bring some kind of a gloomy effect. And then I mixed some black soot oxide ink and some wilted violet oxide ink with water and added even more texture and contrast to this wall. Next I worked on the floor. I used my stripe backdrop to cut some stripes out of a wood grain cardstock, and to get a whole cohesive look on my card, I added texture on those pieces as well. I started by applying black soot oxide ink on the long edges of each stripe, and then I mixed that same black soot oxide ink again with water and splattered lots of drops on all the stripes to stain them. The kitties are cute, but they're pretty messy. So here we have the grey wood planks, the main panel, and off-screen I created a similar one that will go on the front of my center picture window card. I set this second brick panel aside and folded the main panel in half, right on the score line that the die creates. And then I attached the wood planks on the second half of the panel using double-sided tape. I folded the panel and just tucked the first one against the score line. And then I attached the other ones next to each other, and the last wood plank will go on the front of the card. So next I trimmed all those wood planks to get a nice floor. But then the edges were not matching the look, so I used black soot oxide ink again to darken those edges and this way get a whole consistent look. Next I moved on to the front of the card and started by cutting my second brick panel right on the score line. And I used this oval die from the center picture window die set to create an opening in this panel. I flipped my panel upside down and placed the second brick panel on the bottom section. I made sure that it was lined up with the main panel at the back. I applied liquid glue in the center, and then I attached the oval shape on this blank spot. Next, I stuck the window panel on a piece of acetate that I trimmed off screen. And then at the back of the window panel, I attached sticky foam strips. Those strips are very thin and they are bendable and easy to stick to follow non-regular shapes. So I attached those strips at the back of the window panel all around the oval window. I added some more at the corners as well. And then I applied powder all along those foam strips. This way the sequins won't be all stuck on the foam and will move nicely behind the window. Of course I cleaned the window, I just used a microfiber cloth to remove the excess of powder. On the main panel I placed 3 spoons of sequins right on the oval shape. This mix is from Piquet Fan Studio and is called City of Lights. And next I attached the window panel on top of the sequins, but the foam was not sticky anymore, I think I used too much powder. So I just added a bit of liquid glue on the strips, and then I was able to assemble both elements, and this way complete my small shaker panel. And one final thing, I attached the remaining wood plank at the bottom of this shaker panel. I trimmed the excess on the edges and then I did the same thing as I did on the inside wood planks. I added a bit of black soot oxide ink on the edges to get a coordinating look. Next step was the coloring. I stamped all the images using Lanfone Jet Black ink and it looks like a kitty is missing here. As always, I used the coordinating dies to cut them all and then colored everything using my alcohol markers. I went with grey and black for the kitties and hats for example, and also used pinks, blues, purples and greens to match the colors on the brick walls. Once all the images were colored, I started to assemble and stick everything on the front of the card first, with a kitty that is learning spells in the grimoire by candlelight. Next, I moved on to the inside of the card, and before creating the interactive pop-up mechanism, I needed to attach all the images on the wall panel, and I used liquid glue to keep everything as flat as possible, so we have the fireplace with the witch broom on the side, some pumpkins, some old spell books and potions, a few spiders, of course, what would be a Halloween card without any spider, and a cute worm looking for a few extra candy. To create the pop-up mechanism, I used the small hill border die from the center picture window die set. I cut two of those pieces out of acetate and folded the score lines on both pieces. And just so you can see better, I cut the same elements out of scrap paper. This is how it will go. The first element will go against the fireplace, just like so. You make sure that the middle score line on this element is lined up with the middle line of the panel, and then you fold the flaps behind to stick them to the fireplace at the top and to the wood planks at the bottom. So I did this process with the acetate elements. I took the first one and aligned it with the middle line of the panel. I folded the top flap behind to stick to the fireplace. Next, I folded the acetate in half and folded the panel to stick the wood planks to the bottom flap. See, now we have our first element in place. The second element will go against the first one, just like so. I could have kept one single acetate element, but then the cauldron would have been too close to the fireplace, and everything would have been squeezed in the back. So I attached this second acetate element to the first one and to the wood planks. It's not perfect, but it's gonna work anyway. And then I stuck the last remaining images, the kitties with their witch hats, the cauldron, and some more candy. I stuck the cauldron directly on the acetate, and then I attached the kitties on the cauldron sides. Finally, I added the second part of my sentiment. The first one on the front says trick or treat, and on the inside it says no tricks, just treats. And that goes very well with the cauldron full with candy. As always, I finished my card with some white details using a gel pen, highlights on the images, and some dot and cross details on the wall to bring a shine effect. I also did those cross details on the potion bottles. I hope that this card will inspire you to maybe use the same pop-up technique. I will see you very soon in the next video. Thanks for watching and have a very nice day. Bye!